everybody.
Hey, we're back.
I'm
Gabby.
We
got a lot to talk about. I'm Irene.
This is Peyton.
Hey.
Hello. I've
been having him around lately. He's here anyway.
And look at that man.
Adds a nice male voice to the pod. And plus, he's nice to look at.
And plus, he's your boyfriend. And you kiss him on the lips.
You're fucking stupid. Hi, and welcome back to the show. I have a list of things that I'm so excited to talk about that I thought we were going to talk about on last week's episode, but then we ended up just talking about Onision and Aaron Hernandez.
Yeah.
So, Predators and Killers.
Which, all good.
Oh my God, that's the name of a podcast, Predators and Killers.
I bet you it is. How much do you want to bet that that's the name of a podcast?
I don't want to bet
but
that
not
much
monetarily.
Because my AdSense is low right now.
Let's bet just for gentleman's word.
I bet it exists.
I used to say, Dad, bet me. And he'd go, I bet my word. And I was like, fuck. All right.
Damn.
What was it? Predators and Killers?
Also, Peyton said after last episode that he felt that he didn't want to interrupt. And I just want everybody to know that Peyton is allowed to speak whenever he wants.
Of course.
I'm just chilling.
Did I give you that impression?
I'm just here chilling.
I'm sorry.
Why are you leaning so far away from Irene?
I'm very scared. She's like, ha, but for real.
She's like, no, but actually you're out of frame. Timo just texted me something very funny.
What did he say?
I'll show you later.
All right.
Okay, so let's talk about the stuff that we didn't get to talk about last time. And the first thing I'd like to talk about is I'm very perturbed by the fact. Not perturbed. That's not the right word. I recently found out that Martin Luther King Jr. and Frank and Barbara Walters were born the same year. And if Anne Frank and MLK were alive.
No.
They would be the same age as Barbara Walters.
Wild.
And we look at them like they're this different era because they've been dead for so long. So all the footage that we see of them are like
Barbara Walters
stories.
Is not dead.
Well, no, but MLK
Frank, yeah.
Like when you think about Anne Frank, you think like,
I think,
damn, centuries ago.
Truly.
Even though you know the years and stuff, yeah. You're like, damn, that was so long ago.
That makes sense though, because it was in the 40s that she died and she was only, what, 12, 13?
Like, bro, my grandma was older than Anne Frank for real.
It's probably because all the pictures that we have are in black and white.
Yeah.
So it just
yeah.
sticks in your head that all those pictures yeah. are black and white.
And like MLK was so far before any of us were born, but Barbara Walters is just like walking around.
Chilling.
But how crazy is that?
That is insane, dude.
Yeah. Another thing I wanted to talk about is, did you guys hear that it took 7 whole years? This is a very huge advancement in technology, medicine, history. This is massive. And I'm actually so impressed by what we can do today in our society with
I'm
our technology.
To hear this.
So did you guys know that we have recreated the voice of an Egyptian mummy?
What?
Yeah. So we actually
is it
have,
like just from the mummy where he goes?
No. So it took 7 years, and they recreated its vocal tract. So they basically like looked at what its vocal cords looked like and recreated it, and this is what it sounds like. 7 years.
Let's
am
go.
I? Is it gonna be spooky?
Yes.
Oh. Wait.
One more time.
Creepy is the word. And also, why would you want to do that?
Yeah.
Why would you want to hear a mummy's voice?
Yeah, we didn't need just that.
Shouldn't we be like curing cancer?
We don't need this.
You know why?
Why?
People can stick it in memes.
It's so weird.
That reminded me of the dinosaurs from Jurassic Park, where they use like chickens and goats for the dinosaur noises that you told me.
Dude,
bro,
that's insane.
It literally sounds like a dumb effect on like an app. Like, I'm so happy we spent 7 years recreating.
Dude, that was
what
somebody's
an Egyptian
job.
Mummy sounded like going.
Somebody left work that day very satisfied.
But,
like, yo, I did it.
Yeah.
I finally did it.
For real.
It also sounds like a straight up computer, though.
I was going to say that could be anything. We just believe it.
That's the thing. It sounds like somebody yeah. said, we're going to figure out what a mummy sounds like. And then 7 years later, they're like, oh, fuck.
It's kind of like...
Oh, I forgot to study that.
Yeah, he's like, oh shit, I've just been dicking around in the office. The deadline's up tomorrow.
I've been dicking around for 7 years. Yeah. It's the due date when you put off your paper.
He got like a calendar reminder the night before.
Yeah.
Tomorrow, turn in what that mummy sounds like.
Turn in mummy voice.
Fuck, that's so good.
He opens his audio files. He's like, but no, that's not what it would sound like. No,
no, straight up, this sounds like something. Do you know those keyboards where you can set
like
to
make a human voice?
No, you can make like a human voice. You can make like, oh, I want my keyboard to sound like a trumpet, a violin. And
yeah,
you can
make
the keys that sound like the human voice one. And it's so fucking bad, dude. But that's like when they tell us what dinosaurs looked like, and we're just like, okay, yeah, sure. Yeah. We don't fucking know.
Also, the depiction of most dinosaurs is completely inaccurate. Like, most dinosaurs had feathers, and nobody's talking
about
it.
Dude, that's what I'm saying, my guy.
For real.
T-Rex could have had feathers. We don't
fucking
know. Did.
Did. That's what I'm saying.
They could have had long hair.
They could have had long arms, and everybody's...
T-Rex with a ponytail.
We could have just not found the T-Rex's, like, ulna bone, and everybody's tripping, thinking they have tiny-ass arms.
Damn. Do we need to do an ad?
It's just 7 minutes.
Both right now?
Is it the Rothy's one?
Oh my God, she just held up the sign to let us know. I said, do we need to do an ad? And then she picked up the ad paper and said, yes. Okay, do I do both or one? Guys, we're doing two ads today.
Hey.
Which is slightly less than last week's. Four by exactly 50%. However,
okay, science.
Look at all the paper. know? All right. The first one I want to talk about is one that I love so fucking much.
Yo.
And that is Rothy's. I've already had Rothy's for years.
Yeah.
But you just got your first pair.
So here's the tea. I met up with my buddy from high school like 2 months ago, and I was like, oh my God, your shoes are so cute. She was like, they're Rothy's. They're made from water bottles. You can wash both parts. Like, they're so easy to maintain. And da da da. And I was like, oh, cool. Like, they're really cute, whatever. And then when we started the podcast and Dustin was like, oh, Rothy's, I was like, it's a sign from heaven. And I can absolutely confirm that the loafers that I got are the best shoes.
Those
I've ever
are
had.
The best ones.
I love them.
Those are really
I got
are.
The black loafers and I'm fatal.
I recommend that if you do try a pair, I like the loafers. If you're going to start with them, try that. They're super, super comfortable. There's a ton of styles. They go with really anything you're wearing with pants, dresses, skirts, like for real. Dress them up, dress them down. They come in lots of prints and patterns, and they're made out of recycled water bottles. Which is so dope because we have so many fucking water bottles. Hey, most of those water bottles that we recycle going in the garbage for real.
Until they're made into thread because of Rothy's.
Make you feel good about the environment. Make your feet feel good. They're cute as hell.
Yeah.
And go to rothys.com/thoughts to get your new favorite flats. And yeah, they're bomb. Next, we want to talk about
Bumbas.
How often do you think about your socks? If you're
literally
like,
every day. I'm so glad you asked.
If you're like I used to be, not much.
But we've changed, and here's why.
But I recently discovered socks that changed the way I'll think about socks forever. They're called Bombas. They're the most comfortable socks in the history of feet. They're super soft. They're made out of natural cotton. Every pair comes with arch support, seamless toe, and a cushioned footbed that's comfy but not too thick. Let me tell you, that matters. It sounds like it doesn't, but especially if you're running, if you're on your feet all day, if you're a nurse, if you're working out.
Mama wants somebody to hug her foot.
For real.
And Bombas are going to do it.
Yo, it's like a weighted blanket for your feet, bitch. Bombas are what feet daydream about. And for every Bombas purchase you make, Bombas donates a pair to someone in need.
Cutie.
So buy your Bombas at bombas.com/Gabby today and get 20% off your first purchase. That's bombas.com/Gabby.
Woo.
You reminded me of something I want to talk about that is so fucking weird.
Hook me up.
Nothing has come of it, but it still feels weird. Do you know what I'm talking about? The Blair White thing?
It was
just like this weird fucking thing where there was a series of events that led it to happen. And then when it happened, I was like, huh? So, you know, I train in Culver City every morning. Mm-hmm. Like I wake up, I fucking drive an hour, work out, come back. And there's very few days that I don't do that. For whatever reason, I woke up on Tuesday and I was like, I don't want to go to the gym this morning. I feel like I should stay home, get some emails done, get some housework done, whatever. So to, I'm doing my housework. I'm organizing, I'm repotting plants and shit. Cause I don't know, I'm 28. And I was just binge watching videos of like debates and stuff. And then Blair White came up and I watched a couple of her things. And for some reason I was actively thinking about her all day. Do you know who Blair White is? Okay. I'll tell you about her later. But I was actively thinking about her all day. She's a YouTuber, who has very different opinions than a lot of people on YouTube. I think that's why she's interesting to watch. Because she's trans, but
I do know her.
A lot of people like call her a transphobe, even though she's trans, and it's interesting to hear her speak.
Yeah, so anyways, I've watched one or two of her videos, and I was like, wow, enlightening.
Yeah, I appreciate somebody who isn't afraid to publicly go against the crowd, which is what she does, and I think that that's awesome. Whether or not you agree with her, you have to respect the.
Yeah, everybody has a right to their opinion. Doing. Like, it, yeah. even if most people think it's shitty, like, sorry, but that's what it is.
But on that note, there was one thing that she said in there where she was saying, like, yeah, that's the internet. That's what they do. So then I went to this class at Crunch, which I go to, but, like, not that often. Like, it was weird that I last minute decided not to do that today. And then I was in the elevator literally thinking about that, like, that sentence. And I said in my head, I was like, Blair White. Like, I just said her name because I was thinking about it. And then the elevator doors open and it was her.
Whoa.
And I was like, Blair? And she went, yeah. And I was like, holy shit, I was just binging you all day. She went, really? And I was like, yeah.
This happened today?
This was Tuesday.
Oh,
and
my
then
God.
As she was with somebody and they're like, is this going down? I was like, no, up. And then the elevator closed. And I was like, I feel like this means something.
Whoa.
Right? Like, it was so bizarre. Like, I didn't go to the gym that morning. I decided to take that class. I was late for the first class, for the second class. So, like, the fact that I was there at that specific time in the first place was weird because I was in between two classes.
Yeah.
There were just, like, way too many things that led up to me saying her name in my head and then the door opening and her being there.
That's insane.
That's what I'm saying. I don't know what it means, but, like, I DM'd her. She didn't answer. I don't know. I was like, I don't think you're the type of person to, like, believe in this shit. Like, you don't strike me as someone to believe in it.
To
but
be like, whoa.
I was like, there's something here.
That's crazy.
Yeah. I also wanted to talk about, is there anything you want to talk about? Because I'm just going.
I just want to talk about predictions Twitter, because that shit
That's on my list of things I want to talk about, because snap, bitch. The one that you sent me was fucking crazy. But also, how much do they tweet?
That's what I was thinking. I wanted to get into it. Like, I also wanted to look up 2019 predictions.
Yes.
So I'll look those up.
2020 predictions. So do you think they just changed their handle every year? Or do you think somebody reserved the handles for the next 100 years when they made it? Ooh, like 2019 question. Predictions, 2020 predictions.
It looks like maybe that is the case, because these are all like random, like 2019 prediction 274, like, not.
Irene sent me one that said, where is it? A popular beauty YouTuber will come out as transgender. Mm-hmm. And then Nikki Tutorials came out as transgender. When did they tweet that? That was last year in August. They said that.
Damn.
That's.
This shit gives me chills so hard.
Which one?
Just
that one?
Like, predictions being right, that kind of stuff. Just.
Yeah, I want to see what else is in here, because
Justin and Hailey Bieber will divorce.
I don't know. See, here's that one's so specific that would be easier to say whether or not it's legit, because that's two big names.
Yeah.
But this is like a beauty guru, a popular YouTuber.
That one just seems like it depends on the success of Yummy.
Selena Gomez will release an EP.
Oh, it says Julian and Jenna Marbles will get engaged.
Billie Eilish will win Best New Artist at the Grammys. Probably.
Yeah, I think so.
When is that? Next month?
I think so. Award season's like February usually.
It's coming up really soon because they announced all of the nominees and stuff like that.
Ooh, there's an Adele documentary. My mom's gonna be hyped.
Right?
I mean, I love Lizzo so much. And I think that I think her rise is like, it's tough because like hers was more of like an explosion.
No, Lizzo's?
Yeah, dude.
Nah.
Really?
I say that's a hard no. Lizzo's been at it forever.
No,
I remember,
I'm saying she like popped off and people started recognizing how great she was this year. I think
I don't think that's true, because her first big hit was like 4 years ago.
Which one was that?
I do my hair. Good as hell. Check.
Well, but I'm saying it was not nearly as big as Truth Hurts was, even though Truth Hurts came out.
No, but that's why I'm saying what you're saying isn't true. She wasn't a big pop off because that means her first big hit would have been her first big hit. But Good as Hell was huge when it was out. But like people didn't swarm it the way people swarmed it. But she was still a gradual climb. She put out a hit, she put out a hit, and then she put out a massive hit. I think Billie is also a really slow climb. Because Ocean Eyes came out like 4 or 5 years
ago. Was that her like first big one?
Yeah, Ocean Eyes was huge. Ocean Eyes came out when she was 13.
Are you serious?
She was 13 and now she's 18. So yeah.
Holy crap.
So both of them have been grinding for a long time.
Yeah, I'm not trying to say they're not. They haven't been going at it for a long time. It just seems like as of recently, Lizzo got way bigger, whereas I've heard Billie's name for a longer time, I guess.
Hmm.
But that also might just be the people that I'm around, like the little girls that I babysit and stuff, like love Billie. Yeah. So like maybe
no, I
I've
see what
heard
you're
it.
Saying. But Lizzo was nominated for Best New Artist last year, it looks like, and Billie was not.
Oh, for sure.
I think. It's such a tough call because they're, yeah, so she was nominated last year as well, which would actually say that Lizzo was popping off longer.
Yeah.
Because Billie wasn't even on the radar, it looks like, for the Grammys.
When do the nominations for this year come out?
Oh, but Billie didn't have an album. Can you only be nominated if you have an album?
I know so little about the music industry.
Yeah, Billie put out her first album, When We All Fall Asleep, Where'd We Go, which was what? That was a while ago. I don't fucking know. Anyways, I'm sure all of the artists on there.
January 26th.
Oh,
was when We All Fall Asleep?
The Grammy Awards are the 26th of this month, so like a couple weeks.
Oh, okay. Who's your money on? 2020 predictions.
I just looked up all of that list of people that were nominated, and I saw the Black Panthers or Black Pumas.
Yeah.
So I did a quick search on them, and they're described as Wu-Tang Clan meets James Brown.
Oh, okay.
And I'm very interested in that, and I got to look that up.
Yeah. Peyton's a big, big music guy. For people who don't know,
I'm shocked I haven't heard of them.
Yeah,
maybe
he knows
I have
everything.
And I just didn't recognize it.
Mm, I feel like that happens a lot.
Not hearing it, not recognizing it.
Yeah.
Yeah, for sure.
Being like, I love this person. And then like 4 months later, they're like, this is them. And you're like, oh shit.
Yeah, I probably don't see them winning Best New Artist though, just because I feel like
there's 4 people in this room that don't know the name.
Yeah.
It's pretty subjective. But then like that one time Beck beat fucking Beyonce. You know what I mean? Remember that?
No.
You don't remember when Beck beat Beyonce? Kanye pulled like a Taylor Swift 2 on that moment.
Really?
Yeah. Do you remember that, Pei?
No. Beck, but I believe it.
I don't think, maybe it was for Album of the Year.
Yeah, because the Taylor Swift thing was Music Video of the Year, right?
Yeah, and then Beck won, I believe, Album. And then Kanye said in an interview that it was like fucked up, essentially. Sam Grammys, Album of the Year. Yeah, and then that became a big meme of people comparing Beck to Beyonce and like how many writers are on Beyonce's versus Beck and blah, 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 blah. And it's like, you know, it doesn't matter. At the end of the day, this isn't a popular vote thing either. So you never really know how it's going. So like one of those other people can win because they can. But I think when you look at whole like discography, I feel like Billie has a lot more songs that a lot more people know. Like when I think of Billie right off the bat, I'm like, When We All Fall Asleep, Where Do We Go? I'm thinking Bellyache. I'm thinking of Copycat. I'm thinking of Birthday Party or Party Favor. I'm thinking of, like, there's so many different songs. Ocean Eyes. What's her biggest one? Bad Guy. With Lizzo, it's like Good As Hell, Juice. Truth Hurts.
Because I love you.
And I love Lizzo.
Yeah.
But I feel like Billie has
just like a wider breadth.
Because I think she hits that like teenage girl demo.
Dude, hard. Girls want to be her.
Yeah.
Like, it's crazy. The like 13-year-olds that I babysit.
Yeah, but that When the Party's Over song is fire though.
I've only heard like a couple Billie Eilish songs.
Yeah, no, she's very talented. She's very good. And her brother is an incredible writer too.
So. Yeah.
Hey, so Mr. Peanut died. What's up?
Okay.
I did want somebody to talk about that because I was so curious what happened.
Why didn't you bring it up?
I did a story on my Instagram. We're at 25. I did a story on my Instagram where I was like, oh my God, Mr. Peanut died. And I was like trying to be somber, but like obviously it was fake. And like everybody was like, is everything okay? And I was like, Did you not hear the fucking thing? I said, Mr. Peanut died.
I only knew it from you because, yo, that has no traction on it. How did you find that? You always find the weirdest shit on the internet for real. Like, for real?
What else?
You like the Kool-Aid thing. Why did you know Kool-Aid retweets every tweet that says, oh yeah, in it? And why does Irene know that?
Well, that was my own personal observation. Whereas the Mr. Peanut thing was on a Twitter.
But
moment.
Why was that your own personal observation? What the fuck? Because
I follow Kool-Aid.
Why were you on Kool-Aid Twitter?
Why are you not on Kool-Aid
Twitter? I don't
Twitter?
Have Twitter, so I don't see it.
Listen, I got to take Peyton's side on this one. I don't like choosing between my boyfriend and my best friend, but like, the fuck you doing on Kool-Aid Twitter?
Because I like. Because I like Kool-Aid. I don't know.
Well, I wonder what Kool-Aid's up to today.
No, you know what it was? I think I follow some other like food Twitters and Instagrams and whatever. And I think somebody like retweeted Kool-Aid. And then I went to Kool-Aid's page and it's so funny. Like, he only tweets, Mr. Kool-Aid only tweets like
the guy.
It's a giant picture with a tiny phone. He only tweets like things that say oh yeah, so like he'll write a brick wall of oh yeah, and then the next tweet will be like him slowly breaking through the oh yeah, like it's crazy.
I get down with
they're
that.
Hilarious. And oh, I was it maybe it was Wendy's, because I love Wendy's Twitter so much.
Their mixtape was fire.
I was about to say Peyton. Okay, go ahead.
No,
go ahead, you start.
No, and so I just so I just noticed that about Kool-Aid.
Did you not know that Wendy's has a mixtape?
I've never heard it though.
Pull it up.
Gladly.
He loves it. It low-key?
Slaps?
Slaps. It's
good.
Oh, yeah,
good. There's hits on there.
There's hits. And who did it? I need to know the voice behind Wendy's.
Is it a girl voice or boy voice?
We were just having coffee and I thought about it. And I was like, yo, remember when Wendy's had a mixtape like last year? But you just want to know who it was.
I want to know who the real girl was, yeah.
It was a girl rapping?
Yeah, of course.
Hell yeah.
It's Wendy.
Yeah, it's Wendy was rapping.
Wendy is rapping.
Okay.
Listen, I need a burger. That's what would feel good. A burger and fries is what would make my sickness go away.
Twitter fingers.
Can we get a little tavern or something?
Of course. Anything you like.
Oh.
Exactly. Exactly.
Dude, here's the thing. I think there are so many ways, just because like I've been in this industry and like I understand, I've done marketing for so long. Like, I think that Wendy's has the best marketing.
Yeah, of course.
Of any brand I've seen ever.
Popeyes maybe. Accidentally crushed it, to be fair.
Popeyes did?
Yeah.
You mean with the sandwich?
With the sandwich? Oh, you got to watch a video pod on that one. What was that? Yes.
Like eating a sandwich. That's also the sign for sandwich.
Oh.
But they did, but I just mean like Wendy's, like they put out a mixtape and like even the cover of the mixtape like looks cool and is interesting and like they're just so good. I saw a tweet from them today. Somebody tweeted at them. It was a picture of like the McDonald's food truck or something. And they were like, Wendy's, what you think about this? And Wendy's replied, it was like, oh, is that a garbage truck? And I was like, that's the tea.
Yo, Wendy's is lit. Sorry for being so distracted just then. I was trying to decide whether it would make my headache worse to take off my glasses or better because they were digging into the side of my head with these headphones.
Probably better.
I feel very uncomfortably sick right now.
Sorry.
We're going to do it, though. Next thing I'd like to talk about, since Mr. Peanut is dead. Oh, you know what? I still don't understand what's going on.
Oh, actually. He died. He died when him and Wesley Snipes and Matt Walsh were driving in the car.
But is he coming back to life, you think?
No, he was 104.
But why would they randomly kill him?
Because I think that they needed some traction on the Peanut game.
So are they gonna, in loving memory of our legume...
Yeah, I didn't forget about Peanuts.
Yeah, nobody did.
I need to revamp it.
Yeah, why? But... Now, are they just making a new logo because they're over Mr. Peanut?
No, I mean, I think it was just a thing that they were like, yo, nobody's talking about us. Let's do this.
And but they changed the Mr. Peanut Instagram to the estate of Mr. Peanut, which is very funny.
I like that.
But I still don't really understand what's going on.
Like why it's happening?
Yeah. And are they doing a rebrand? Because now he's dead. So like
Peanut Gen 2. That's it. All they can do.
Peanut Gen 2. It's just a peanut penguin.
I feel like that was such an iconic logo. I feel like, I mean, we're talking about it now. So great fucking job, Mr. Peanut. You really crushed it with the marketing. So yeah. I get it now. I do understand why they did it. It's because we're talking about it on a podcast and they did not give us this paper.
This paper or this paper.
Same thing. It's a metaphor.
It's nuts.
I need some watermelon. I just need, I feel like my body's like, please give me some fucking nutrients that are going to make me feel better. hey, so question. I'm going to take one ear off because I'm going to ask Lauren. Yo, Lauren, are the Killers British?
Yes.
Okay, here's the fucking thing. No, the fuck they're not. And I did a poll on my Twitter and or on my Instagram. And I said, are the Killers British? And 57% of people think that the Killers are British. And they simply are not. They're from Vegas.
I think that makes sense.
You just said they're British. What do you mean that makes sense?
Yeah, but I mean like, okay, their whole, okay.
they have the very London like punk vibe about them.
Yeah, but what, like, okay, if you grew up in Vegas and then you think like, if you want to be on stage,
mm-hmm.
you do something to go on stage. So why not do it? Like you're in the area where everybody tries to have an act.
No, like, they're not pretending to be British.
No, are they not?
No.
Is that not their shtick?
No, right? They're not.
I think it's their shtick.
They've never once pretended to be British anywhere.
Wait, how did this come up? Like, what made you think of it?
Because one time I said something about the Killers being British. And someone was like, no, they're not. And I was like, yes, they are. And then I Googled it and I was like, oh my God, the Killers are straight up Mormons from Vegas.
We should have asked Dustin because he's from Vegas. So I feel like he'd been like, actually, they're from Vegas.
Yeah, but that's not their shtick. They don't speak in British accents. They don't like wear the British flag.
They don't drive that PT Cruiser that looks like the British flag.
No, there's nothing about them. However, I did find a list that I have not read yet because I wanted to read it on here. You made a good point. You said all bands are from Britain for the most part, like rock bands, like
the Queen, Beatles,
the Doors.
Doors.
Right? The Who.
The Who, for sure. Yes.
Is Yes the band?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, my God.
See.
Okay.
My brother used to be really into Yes, and I didn't realize until like 2 years ago because he's a giant stoner.
Okay, I want to put this out there. When you type in Are the Killers...
I want to know where
the third the third search is Are the Killers British? Okay. So Are the Killers British? Let's see.
Okay, now I solely think it's because of Mr. Brightside, because of when all of us were younger. That was, I think, our first like memory of them.
They're not British in Mr. Brightside.
Wait, the Killers or Mr. Brightside? That's who sings that?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh shit.
I think that they look British.
That's okay, what I'm saying.
Like, yeah, but what does that mean? Like you heard Mr. Brightside and you were like British.
A cliche British.
British.
Just like a cliche, like, okay, they're wearing like what their costumes like, I don't know.
Well, I found this article. It says 7 reasons people think the Killers are British. Hook so we're gonna up. Dive in. Okay. Many people think the Killers who have a new album and tour are British. They're not. Here's why you might be confused. Brandon Flowers sings almost all of Hot Fuss with a British accent. That's one song that I've never heard.
Mm-mm.
So that doesn't mean anything to me. Just listen to the way he sings, It's Killing Me on Mr. Brightside. Look how snooty and British the boys look in this promo shoot from 2004. 2, lots of indie pop rock bands from the early 2000s were British, including but not limited to the Kaiser Chiefs, the Futureheads, Franz Ferdinand.
Dude, oh, I loved Franz Ferdinand.
The Editors. But I don't know any of these bands for me to be like, yeah, that's why they think they're British. So still, I don't understand.
I thought
the
Killers were way older than this. I did not know they were a 2000 band. I thought they were like 70s vibes.
I get that.
Early on, Sir Elton John championed the band's music. He's British. That, I did not know that. So that still does not explain why I thought that the Killers were British. Their first live album and concert movie were recorded at Royal Albert Hall. Did not know that. Have not seen that. Don't know why that means. I would think they're British. Brandon's iconic Dior feather jacket retired to the Hard Rock Cafe in London. No? Is this a satire? It says, if you haven't... 7, the British love them. The Killer singles routinely top UK charts. I don't live to be fair, actually, I think I did live in the UK when that's very funny. If you haven't listened to The Killers in a while, check out their new album. By the way, they're from Vegas. But dude, isn't that weird?
That's like a Mandela effect thing.
I'm actually on the Mandela effect subreddit trying to figure it out.
Thank the Mandela effect. That's the first place I go. Fucks me up.
Dude, that's so weird and stresses me out so badly that everybody was just like, yeah, they're British. Like, we didn't think that Panic at the Disco was British.
Are they not?
Are you being funny?
No.
You thought Panic was British?
I don't know. No, I thought you were saying they are British.
Oh, no. I'm saying to apply that logic, does it make sense? Because like...
Oh, Panic, like just saying this band's British.
Yeah, same era, same style, same vibe. I guess I'm coming out of my cage and I've been doing just fine.
But to me, that sounds more like kind of how Eddie Vedder sings of like... Like just like they have a very specific vocal style as opposed to like an accent.
I'm pretty sure I also just sang that way more British than it actually is.
I'm coming out of my cage and I've been doing just fine. Gotta be gone because I want it all. To me, it doesn't sound Britishy. But also, you can't really hear accents when you sing.
You can very rarely. Like, and after all, you're my wonderwall. Mr. Brightside, which by the way is a fucking bop for sure.
It's like one of those songs that you know all the lyrics to on accident.
Let's see if it sounds British. That's the most un-British thing I've heard. Yeah, I don't fucking know. This is so bizarre. Anyway, The Killers aren't British, guys. Title of this podcast.
The Killers aren't British.
Don't Google it. Are the Killers British?
Funny. Wait, can we do more Mandela effect stuff? Because that stuff fucks me up.
Yeah, let's do it. Why the fuck not?
Look stuff up.
Yo, I can't stop doing this. It's my favorite thing.
I love that.
Verbal meme.
It's so funny.
I love that.
Like, I won't get into this because it's a very sensitive material, but Sydney was telling me about that thing with her brother.
Yeah, yeah.
And she was like, oh, girl, do I have a story for you? And across the table at dinner, I went.
And then you also ended a very intense emotional story with Farizzle?
Literally.
I gotta stop saying that. I'm a bad influence.
It's just funny.
It's funny.
What is it?
I'm looking. Okay. I can't find anything.
Well, the main one that everybody talks about is Berenstain Bears versus Berenstain Bears.
There's one right here.
Yeah, that one's
speaking of the Berenstain something, but I don't think it's relevant to that. Never mind.
Well, there's also Sex in the City versus Sex and the City.
What's the answer on that? Because I don't know.
And, right?
I think it's and, but
I've always known it was and because I see it written. I've never really referenced Sex in the City without, is it and? Yeah, and it's Sex and the City.
Yeah.
Right? But that's because like they show it on the fucking, before every episode, it's like Sex and the City. You know what I mean? That was a weird one to mix up.
I think because somebody had like merchandise that said Sex in the City, but the more I thought about it, the more I was like, that might just be some weird knockoff merchandise that somebody made.
Hey, how about how crazy conspiracy theories are? Because some of them are a little too convincing.
Yeah. I could like, bitch.
Yeah.
I got real into them.
I feel like they've all been covered so many times, though. Holy shit, this migraine's like coming full force for me.
Oh.
You okay?
What do you need?
A cheeseburger and fries.
Vibes. Cheeseburger and vibes. Like Looney... Like, how do you think Looney Tunes is spelled?
L-O-O-L-N-E-Y? T-O-O-N-S?
See, it's not.
Tunes for the music.
It's tunes as in, like, music. Like, a tune.
Oh, you know what? I'm not just saying this.
You knew that.
I thought that's what it was. And then I was like, oh, that can't be right. And then I changed it because I wanted to sound smart. But no, I did think it was T-U-N-E-S. But that's another thing where you see it on the logo. Hey, is that Looney Tunes the ones that we were singing the thing for? Because we saw the Acme.
Animaniacs.
Oh, do you remember the Animaniacs?
We were in Burbank.
Animani, totally insane.
What's the last word?
Animaniacs?
It goes, we're Animani, we're totally insane. And then somebody pops and goes, we're Animaniacs.
Really?
Yeah.
They say mimma, or do they say a word?
No, they say words. I just want to know if you know what it is.
Oh, no.
Do you know what I'm talking about, Lauren?
Wait.
Do you know what I'm talking about, though?
Yes.
My brother and I watch the show so often. Let me Let me think for 1 second.
We are the Animaniacs. We put baloney in our slacks. So just sit back and relax. We're zany to the max. We're animani. We're totally insaney. Wimp, 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 wimp. We're animaniacs. And that's just the facts.
Oh, we're in something? Is it we're in something?
I don't know.
Just give it to me. What is it?
Here's the thing. It changed every episode.
No.
Yes. Do you want to hear all the alternate versions?
Yes, please.
All right, I'm going to find it.
I loved that show desperately. That and Pinky and the Brain. Fuck me up.
I was about to start singing. We're Pinky and the Brain. We're Pinky and the Brain. One is a genius. The other's insane. What is it? Da-da-da-da-da-da. Ba-da-da. I'm pissed because I literally just Googled the lyrics and I would have felt so cool if I remembered it and I would have pretended like I remembered it from childhood. Okay, so here's some of the alternates. Here's the show's namey. Pinky and the Brainy. Come back, Shaney. The Rain and Spainy. Cockamamie. So they changed it every time. There's like a huge list.
Incredible.
Yeah.
God, I would love
Dana
to watch those
Delaney.
Again.
Dana Delaney. Chicken chow mania. Ooh, Chinese food. Right now.
That's the tits.
What?
Is that what you want?
Kind of.
Okay.
Okay.
Quiche Lorraine. Or Quiche Lorraine. That's so funny. High octane. Now I have to look up Pinky and the Brain. We're Pinky and the Brain. This isn't good content. Or is it?
I think a lot of people are probably like, oh, like if this were me listening to a thing in the car, I'd be like, what about this other one? Like, I think it's good.
I feel like
right, guys?
No, yeah. Let us know.
Have you ever been?
Terrible.
Have you ever been listening to a podcast in the car or something, and then you're like, I know, right? Because you think that you're like a part of the conversation.
People tweet us and say that all the time. Did you ever know that theme songs to cartoons and shit they're a full song usually? And we hear like a fraction of it.
For Rizzle?
Yeah. Like, here's the Pinky and the Brain theme song. And it's like long, bro.
It's longer than fucking Old Town Road,
but
I bet.
Most of them are. Do you remember Salute Your Shorts?
Fantastic show.
Yeah. No, I don't.
Zeke the Plumber was a legend.
God, how's the theme song to that go?
Camp Anawana, we hold you in our
Camp
hearts.
Camp Anawana, we hold you in our hearts. Oh, and it goes. At first, it's slow. And when we think about you. And then one kid goes, it makes us want to fart. And then one of them goes, we hold you in our hearts. Because she gets real mad. Because he said fart.
Did you know that the Simpsons intro, like when they all sit on the couch and something happens, was either shortened or lengthened based on how much of the episode they had? So if instead of a 22-minute episode, they only had like 21 and a half minutes, like the intro section would be longer.
Damn. I love that.
Yeah.
Okay. So these are the lyrics of Pinky and the Brain. It's like pretty long.
Oh my God.
So it's like, one is a genius, the other's insane. They're laboratory mice. Their genes have been spliced. They're Pinky and the Brain, 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 Brain. And that's where you think it ends, right?
Yeah.
Before each night is done, their plan will be unfurled by dawning of the sun. They'll take over the world. I don't know the melody.
And that's
this.
Not in the show, right?
No. I don't think so. Do you remember Ren and Stimpy?
I didn't have cable. I never got to watch those cool ones.
I wasn't allowed to watch it because it was fucking insane. And now looking at it as an adult, you weren't allowed either. It's weird. There's like sex and like, it's just dirty. Is it an adult cartoon? Pass for the mic, Pay.
I was gonna say no. Lauren doesn't think so.
Yeah, I don't think so. It's like, what's the one with the turtle? Do you remember?
Oh, Rocko's Modern Life.
Yes.
Rocko's Modern Life.
Gabby loves that show.
Life.
Yeah.
Rocko's
it's
Modern
the same. It's like
life.
It's made for kids, but there's adult jokes.
But so the
no,
parents
but I
can
was,
enjoy it too.
I was allowed to watch Rocko though, for sure. Because Rocko, like he was a sex hotline worker. We didn't know that.
Yes.
Our parents did, but like Ren and Stimpy. That was straight
up. Was that the one
up
with the two guys?
Fucked.
No, that's Beavis and Butthead.
That's Beavis and Butthead. I also wasn't allowed to watch that. Turn the mic around.
Oh my God, that was
now I was
going
to say, this table reminds me of that table from from that episode of Curb.
Room?
No, oh. From Curb Enthusiasm. We're watching where he was complaining about the wobbling table.
Is it wobbling? Oh, it's because it's the mic's too heavy. We watched the new episode of Curb.
Oh, from the new season?
How about how many seasons of Curb there are?
For Rizzle.
Congratulations 10. To Larry David.
Killing it.
I love him so much.
I walked by him one day. Another really weird timing where, like, I didn't know much about Curb because I never had HBO, and then I got into it because somebody got me into it. And then, like, as soon as I got into it, I was walking down the street, and he was just sitting on a park bench filming. And I was like, that's fucking weird as shit.
That is crazy.
It was... Oh, no, you weren't there.
Oh.
It was right after I was with you, though.
That was you that told me a lot of that show's improv, right?
It's all improv. Mm-hmm.
That's great.
It has, like, a very, very loose structure of, like, here's the idea, and then they're like, okay.
Yeah. And I'm sure they have beats they hit. But if you didn't know, Curb Your Enthusiasm is improv, which is... Did you know that, Lauren? Have you ever seen it? Oh, that was
really?
A great show. It's impressive.
Did you like Seinfeld?
I was more of a Friends fan.
Okay, did you like Seinfeld?
No. When it was on, I think I was just more interested in Friends.
I get
oh,
it.
Sure. I grew up watching Seinfeld because my dad said that Friends was like a terrible show and not funny. So I always had this weird bias that like it was just a bad show and everybody was wrong. When my dad died, I was like, I can watch Friends now. And I fell in love with it.
It's good.
I was like, this is the best show I've ever seen.
Tired of people saying Friends isn't good because simply it is.
Yeah, so, oh my God.
This is great.
Somebody tweeted, they were like, if I won the lottery, I would use all of it to take all the laugh tracks out of Friends so everybody could see how not funny it was. And I was like, no, it's funny.
It is a good show. I don't know why people are so insistent.
It wouldn't have been on for 10 years if it wasn't a good show.
Hey, breaking news. This is trending on Twitter right now. Like, it's the biggest Twitter moment, the top Twitter moment.
I thought you were going to say, breaking news, I have a migraine.
I do feel like I'm going to throw up very shortly. James Corden doesn't drive during carpool karaoke.
Yeah, I just saw that, too.
What is up with that?
Isn't that insane?
How does that...
But, I mean, I'm also glad because it didn't
make sense. Oh! Oh, my God. They have the car hitched.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's on
so
a trailer.
So, somebody's driving.
Yeah.
Wow. Of course he doesn't drive.
Do they y'all not have the steering wheel in the shot?
Oh, they said y'all didn't question
they
it when
do.
This happened? Is that fucking...
Wait, pull it closer. I can't see that far.
It's Stevie Wonder.
That is Stevie Wonder, and that was not a joke.
Wow.
That was bad timing.
What was the bad timing?
Nothing. Let's just bypass that because it was...
Oh.
It was very unfortunate.
Nobody's going to be upset with you. That's so funny. Reen, I can't look at screens anymore because I feel like I'm going to fucking puke.
Mm-hmm.
Can you pull up some five... Do you have anything else you want to talk about?
No.
Hey, you have anything you want to talk about?
No, I was really curious about Mr. Peanut, but now I know, so that's good.
Oh, good.
Yeah, he died in a car with Wesley Snipes and Matt Walsh, one of the co-creators of UCB, and they got into an accident, and all three of them were hanging onto a tree branch, and the branch started to break, and he said, we're too heavy. So Wesley was like, I'll let go. And then Matt Walsh was like, no, I will. And then Mr. Peanut was like, stop. And everybody was like, no, Mr. Peanut, you can't. And he was like.
Yeah, but I feel like he's going to come back.
He'll just regrow. Like,
is this all a big thing for toasted peanuts straight up?
I mean, I love me.
Because he died in a fire.
Like just regrowing a peanut.
Damn, that's funny.
If they're watching this far into the podcast, they don't give a fuck anyway.
Night pod. Let's see. Every weekend, oh, this is a very long one, but five. Thanks for sending it.
It's good times.
Oh, hey, this is in reference to.
Is it that dark? You can put it back on.
This is in reference to us talking about the Netherlands in regards to LGBTQ issues.
Mm-hmm.
It says the Netherlands 5 stars from Cherry Blossom. The Netherlands is a world leader on LGBTQ rights. It was the first country to allow transgender people to openly serve in its armed forces in 1974.
Oh, hell yeah.
In 2001, it became the first country to allow gay couples to marry. Found this on an article, and now I'm doing a report on it for schools since you asked about how they dealt with this 11 to 12 years ago.
You know what? That actually, I can't believe that I'm shocked by that at all because thinking about it, because I was like, what, is Europe like so far ahead of us, whatever? Which they are, for sure.
Yeah.
But the Netherlands is where Amsterdam is.
Yeah.
Where
they've
always been down with weed. Like they have the red light district where you can literally walk down and up and down streets and like window shop for sex workers. You know what I mean? Like they're super, super open and super free. Dude, they're one of the like least like violent, like awesome countries, right?
Yeah.
So of course they would be accepting there.
And then let's do this one too. 5 stars. Bros, I just want to start with, I binge the pod and I love you too. I'm taking a year of social media. I'm taking a year off social media, and now I'm listening to podcasts since I have the time.
Whoa.
This episode, I am laughing. I'm literally laughing in the middle of class.
Which episode?
I think 8. Like the most recent one. I'm laughing in the middle of class. It's an independent study class. Okay, love you both. Also, I could literally listen to your voices all the time.
That makes me so happy.
He said, yes, even you, Irene. I'm sorry.
When yes, was, even you.
When was I asking for that?
I love it because it's like, I'm going to give you this really sweet compliment, but also like, yeah, I know. He's basically saying your voice is annoying.
Of course.
On accident.
Of course.
Wow. Read one that's mean about me. Do we ever get mean ones in there?
Yeah.
Oh, like the 5 stars?
No.
That makes sense.
Okay, so first off, amazing podcast. I look forward to it every Tuesday. But have you seen a quokka? Because they're referring to when we talked about how cute voles are. They're the most adorable mammal I've ever seen, and they look so happy all the time. Anyways,
can you Google a picture of someone?
Yeah. Spell anyways, it. Love you so much. See you next week.
Wait, Lauren's going to Google it. Do you want to go to Twitter and grab some or see if there's any stories in the DMs?
Yeah.
Are you logged into the Instagram?
No.
Okay. I'll look into it.
Somebody said, listen, I don't know how to write a 5-star review, but I feel like I'm one of the gals hanging out. Sometimes reply before realizing I'm not there. One time I responded, my mom thought people snuck into my room.
That's fucking awesome.
I need some advice. My family constantly fights, and usually it's right in front of me. Whenever my parents yell at each other, it hurts a little piece inside of me all the time. I don't know what to do, and I feel trapped.
Wait, repeat the second half.
Whenever my parents yell at each other, it hurts a little bit inside, and it hurts a little bit inside. I just don't know what to do, and I feel trapped.
Oh, that's so sad.
I used to
lock my bedroom door and blast Panic at the Disco, which is such a funny, like, emo teenage girl thing to do. But it's a funny thing because it's, like, real. Like,
yeah.
It's a cliche because that's what happens. Because
it drowns that out. I know when my parents fought, it just made me so deeply, like, not even, like, upset, which it did, but it just made me uncomfortable. I was like, can you guys
not?
Like, yeah. We're right fucking here.
Yeah.
So I would just like go on a walk a lot of the time. Be like, I'm going to go.
Yeah.
I got to call my friend for homework.
And just like wait and know that you're going to be older soon. Try to distract yourself. Join clubs, sports, stay out of the house, exercise, go for runs.
Oh, this one's cute. This girl did a boomerang and she said cleaning the apartment, but not doing it alone. Thank God for Box of Thoughts.
I love that.
Oh, sweet. This one's just a cutie. I was so late to hearing the podcast, so when I started it, I binge listened to all of the episodes in a couple days. Now that I'm done with all of them, I don't know what to do with myself. Hashtag Box of Thoughts, by the way.
I love
you guys.
That. That's so exciting.
Dude, that's so cool. I remember when I found my favorite podcast, and there were like 100 episodes, and I was like, oh my God, this is incredible. Like, this is perfect. I get to listen to them as long as I want. And then when I finally caught up, I didn't realize I had. And I was like, all right, on to the next. And I was like, that was it.
Yeah.
It's a very like,
who was it?
My Favorite Murder. It's like when you are watching a new Netflix show and you're like, okay, next episode, and like that was the last one of the season, and you're like,
yeah.
I have to wait a year.
Yeah.
But then you forget about that show and then the new episodes come out and you're like, hell yeah, and you do the same thing all over again.
For real. That's what I do with Crystal Lee. I listen to them all and then I haven't listened to them in months. So when I go back again, I'm gonna be like, hell like, yeah.
A whole bank.
All right, guys, checking out early, kind of already checked out like 10 minutes ago. Go throw up. Yeah. Thank you guys for listening. Leave us a 5-star review. We will read our favorite ones on air, whether they're mean or silly or helpful or interesting, whatever it is. You can tweet us your questions with hashtag Box of Thoughts. I'm Gabby, this is Irene, and that is Peyton over there. And subscribe to the YouTube, I guess.
Oh, right. And our producer, Lauren. Thanks.
Hi, Lauren. You want to show your face or no?
She's like, they've seen my back. That's enough.
All right. Bye, guys.
Bye. Goodbye.